Season 8 of Fortnite Battle Royale is just about a month away from releasing, as February 28th is when Season 8 will launch, completely turning the Fortnite world upside down if some of our leaks end up coming to fruition. The dragon eggs pose some serious problems going forward, as does the melting of the snow. And come Season 8, we might even see the return of the gifting system. We'll be covering all of this and then some in this video, so make sure you stay tuned all the way till the end so you can be up to date with all of the latest Season 8 news. What's up guys, and welcome back to the Simply Viral channel. Thanks for stopping by. If you're new around here, feel free to subscribe with your channel notifications turned on by clicking that little bell button, that way you'll always know when a new video goes live. If you guys are excited for Season 8 of Fortnite Battle Royale, let us know by giving this video a big thumbs up and slapping that like button, and be sure to comment down below what you're most excited about for Season 8. Now without further ado, let's jump back into the world of Fortnite to take a look at some brand new Fortnite Season 8 leaks and rumors. As I mentioned, Season 8 of Fortnite will be launching on February 28th, which is just about a month away from now, meaning that within the next 4 weeks or so, we're going to be seeing some serious updates come to the game that will inevitably hold some big teases and leaks within them. To kick things off today, let's focus on the dragon eggs that are mysteriously hanging out in the bottom of the ice castle located at Polar Peak. Currently, we don't really know a whole lot about these eggs, as they have remained a mystery since they were originally found in the game files, but we do know that there are 5 eggs in total, each of which has a shadow or a silhouette of a weird dragon or serpent-like creature that can be seen on the shell of each individual egg. We also know that if you listen closely, the eggs can sometimes be heard thumping like a heartbeat, meaning that whatever is inside of these ominous eggs is going to hatch sometime soon. There's currently 2 main rumors going around right now about these eggs, the first of which is some sort of Game of Thrones crossover. Conveniently enough, Game of Thrones will be returning for its 8th season on April 14th, and Fortnite will be launching into its 8th season at the end of February. While this rumor seems pretty solid, seeing as dragons are a pretty prominent character in Game of Thrones, the distance between the 2's release dates sort of discredit the possibility of these eggs having to do with Game of Thrones, unless it's some super early sort of teaser event. With that being said though, we can't fully rule out anything just yet. The other main theory going around about these eggs right now is that they actually have something to do with Chinese New Year's, as the silhouette of the dragons on the eggshells is very similar to the dragons that appear with Chinese New Year's. Lucky Landing does already sort of have a Chinese New Year's vibe going on with it, and perhaps these dragons will end up hatching on February 5th, which is when Chinese New Year's begins this year. Fortnite has been closely mirroring the real-world events for quite some time now, as previously we had the Fort Nightmares event for Halloween and the 14 Days of Fortnite event for the holiday season. So I really wouldn't be surprised if Epic Games is planning some sort of other real-world crossover event with the Dragon Eggs coming in early February. Plus, that timing, roughly 3 weeks or so before Season 8 launches on the 28th, leaves just enough time for the aftermath of the dragons hatching to carry us into our next season. It should also be noted that there are exactly 5 dragon eggs, and there's also conveniently 5 seats sat around the grand table on the main floor of the ice castle. Perhaps this is just a coincidence, or maybe there's a reason that there is specifically 5 dragon eggs and 5 seats. Perhaps 1 egg per person or 1 dragon per person is in effect here. We have to assume that 2 of those 5 seats belong to the Ice King, our tier 100 skin, and the Ice Queen, our more recent item shop skin. But who do those other 3 seats belong to then? Perhaps there's some sort of Fire King or Fire Queen, or maybe a Water King or Water Queen. We're gonna have to keep an eye out for any future teases coming in the following weeks to see if we have maybe a potential battle for superiority in the midst between various kings and queens of different elements. I'm just saying it would be really cool to see some sort of battle go down between these 5 kings and queens, and that'd be one cool event to actually witness in-game. Moving on, the recent Ice Storm event was another huge success for Fortnite Battle Royale, although out of all the events that we've had so far, that being the Rocket Launch and the Butterfly event, I think most people are agreeing that the Ice Storm event was the least exciting of them all. Regardless though, the Ice Storm event completely changed the Fortnite map and engulfed it entirely in snow and ice. And if the trend of following the real-world seasons continues like it has for the past 2 seasons, that means that all of the snow and ice is going to melt away rather quickly, which poses some serious problems for the Fortnite island. Originally, we were thinking that the iceberg melting was going to cause the western portion of the Fortnite map to potentially be flooded and maybe even destroyed. But now that the entire Fortnite island is completely covered in snow, this means now the entire island is at risk of being flooded or even completely destroyed. While I don't think the entire Fortnite map will completely disappear, as our single map has become a pretty big staple here in Fortnite, honestly, I do think that this potential flood event could drastically change the map as we know it. Dusty Divot and the center area of the Fortnite island has remained relatively untouched since the meteor crashed into it some time ago, and really since then, the center of the island has become a pretty boring place to be around. There's really not that much loot, it's pretty open, so you're constantly at risk of being shot at, and generally it's just an avoided area by all means, so it's definitely due for some sort of change. In this case, Dusty Divot could be flooded, creating a brand new water-based point of interest that would completely change the center of the island. The divot is one of the lowest points on the map, meaning that if the snow does end up melting realistically, the divot would be prone to some extreme flooding, and seeing as some water has already made its way into the divot, I think that if a flood event does end up happening, we could have a massive new lake in the center of the Fortnite island, and potentially even the ability to go and loot Dusty Divot underwater. This obviously is just a rumor, but it seems pretty possible seeing as the map is due for some major changes, so it's definitely worth keeping an eye on Dusty Divot for the time being. Now let's shift focus to the gifting system, something which literally every Fortnite player was thrilled to finally gain access to not too long ago. Unfortunately, when the gifting system was released, we were unaware that the system that we had was actually a beta test of the real gifting system and would only be around for a few weeks. Initially, after months and months of waiting, when the gifting system finally released into Fortnite, players everywhere were incredibly excited to be able to give and receive skins and other items. However, only a few weeks after the gifting system launched, it was removed, and Epic Games stated that it would return at a later date. Well, here we are, over halfway through Season 7, honestly, the majority of the way through Season 7 now, and we have no gifting system information. It's clearly not in the game, and we have no idea when it could be coming back. With that being said, though, seasonal updates are always huge, and they're pretty much always filled with some sort of surprise, meaning that potentially, and keep in mind this is just a rumor and not confirmed, the gifting system will be coming back to Fortnite Battle Royale in Season 8. It is a long shot, I'm gonna admit, but Epic Games always do have a few tricks up their sleeve, and re-releasing the gifting system would be an absolutely huge surprise to accompany the Season 8 launch. To wrap things up, we've also gotta mention that in just about a week, we're finally going to be able to unlock the long-awaited Snowfall skin, aka our challenge-based skin here in Season 7. This skin will physically become one of the rarest in the game, as it's currently the hardest challenge-based skin to unlock that we've ever seen, and it's only available to unlock during Season 7. Previously, all of our other challenge-based skins, like the Blockbuster skin, the Enforcer skin, and the Aim skin were all unlocked in Week 7 of their respective seasons, after a player completed each one of the weekly challenges for Weeks 1 through 7. Now though, in Season 7, we have to wait until Week 9 in order to complete our challenge-based skin, the Snowfall skin, and we have to complete a total of 60 challenges in order to unlock it, making it the hardest challenge-based skin we've ever had. And now when you look back, the skins like the Blockbuster skin and the Enforcer skin and the Aim skin are all super rare, seeing as you cannot unlock them anymore and you never will be able to again, presumably. So the Snowfall skin is going to be a super big deal come Week 9, which is just a couple of days away now. In the past, all of those other challenge-based skins have played a prominent role in the seasonal storyline progression, and they've also teased some future seasonal themes. And I see no reason why things would be any different this time around, meaning that come Week 9, when we finally gain access to the Snowfall skin, or whatever it's officially going to be called, we're gonna have a pretty good idea of where Fortnite is actually headed for Season 8. I'm just saying, if the Snowfall skin is wearing an inner tube and some floaties, we can definitely expect a flood event to happen. But if the skin is wearing some sort of medieval helmet or some armor, maybe we're gonna see some dragons reign over the island. Until that time comes though, the Snowfall skin remains a mystery. With that being said though, that effectively wraps up this video. If you guys enjoyed it or if you're excited for Fortnite Season 8, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and slap that like button, as it would be much appreciated. If you guys are brand new here to the Simply Viral channel, feel free to go ahead and subscribe with your channel notifications turned on by clicking that bell icon, that way you'll never miss another upload. Once again, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and we'll see you guys on the Battle Bus. Peace out.